Ciao e benvenuto. I'm Valentina Stella, native Italian tutor, and in today's video, we're going to learn how to correctly translate boy and girl in Italian. These are probably two words that you have already learned, because these are probably some of the very first words that you learn when learning Italian. So, isn't boy ragazzo and girl ragazza, right? Well, no, it depends. But it depends on what? Well, it depends on the age of the person you're talking about. The first thing I want you to have clear in mind, because this is usually not explained, is that ragazzo and ragazza in Italian, so the way we actually use those words, is that we only use ragazzo and ragazza to talk about people who are teenagers or older. Ragazzo and ragazza is not used in Italy to talk a boy and a girl in the way you're probably thinking when using boy and girl. So ragazzo and ragazza in Italian means a boy or a girl who are teenagers or older. That's it. And I know this may be very different from what you expected. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to learn how to translate boy and girl depending on the age of the person you're talking about. And we're going to do that with some sentences so that you can really absorb these and use that whenever you will need it. But before we do that, if you like these kind of videos, please give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you will be notified when I post a new video of this series or any other video to help you learn and improve your Italian. Okay, let's learn and practice all the different ways to say boy and girl in Italian. Let's start with the most known one. So if you talk about someone who's a teen or older, then you can use ragazzo or ragazza. So ragazzo, of course, is for a boy and ragazza is for a girl. So repeat after me. Ragazzo, ragazza, ragazzo, repeat. Ragazza. Perfetto. So if you wanna say when I was a boy and you refer to you being a teen, like a teen, that would be in Italian quando ero ragazzo. Repeat after me. Quando ero ragazzo. Perfetto. Now if you want to talk about someone who's a preteen, so they are not 13 yet, we use ragazzino or ragazzina for a girl. You probably already encountered this ending, the ino ending. Usually that's used to make something smaller in Italian. So for example, if you have a table, tavolo, a tavolino is a smaller table. Usually that's how we call the coffee table, because the coffee table is just a smaller table that you keep in your living room. So the ino endings is usually used to make things smaller. So that's what we're saying. We're saying that a preteen is a small, meaning in this case, younger boy. So remember, if you talk about someone who's a preteen, do not use ragazzo. That makes us think of someone older, but use ragazzino or ragazzina. So repeat after me, ragazzino, ragazzina, ragazzino, ragazzina. Perfetto. So if you want to say when I was a girl and you're referring to a period over time when you were younger than 13, then you would say quando ero una ragazzina. Repeat after me. Quando ero una ragazzina. Perfetto. Now, if you talk about a kid who's up to about 9 years old, so is someone who's not a teen, is not a preteen, is younger than being a preteen, let's say he's a kid up to 9 years old, so 9 years old or younger, then you will use bambino or bambina. That's what these words mean. Bambino means a kid up to 9 years old. Up to 9 years old, we still call them bambino and bambina, kids. So repeat after me. bambino, bambina, bambino, bambina. Ok. So if you want to say when I was a kid and you're referring to being a kid, then you would say quando ero bambino. Repeat after me. Quando ero bambino. Perfetto. Now, if you want to talk about a toddler, then we have another word, and that's bambino piccolo o bambina piccola. So again, we say that the toddler is a smaller kid. Now, keep in mind the word piccolo literally means small, but in Italian we also use that as younger. So that's what we are saying. Bambino piccolo means a younger, a smaller as in younger kid. So remember, for a toddler, bambino piccolo o bambina piccola. Repeat after me. Bambino piccolo, bambina piccola. Perfetto. So if you want to say we have a toddler girl, that would be abbiamo una bambina piccola. Repeat after me. Abbiamo una bambina piccola. That's how we will understand you're talking of a very young girl. If you want to talk about a newborn, that in Italian is neonato o neonata. Repeat after me. Neonato, neonata. Neonato, neonata. Perfetto. So, if you want to say newborns are so cute, usually they are, that's i neonati sono così carini. Repeat after me. I neonati sono così carini. Molto bene. So let's recap what we learned today. We learned that we have different translations for the words boy and girl depending on the actual age of the person you're referring to. You cannot use ragazzo and ragazza for all ages. When we say ragazzo and ragazza in Italian, we picture someone who's quite old. Well, not old, but teenager or older. Well, as a matter of fact, sometimes in Italy it's not very uncommon to hear people using ragazzo, ragazza for someone who's even older than 20 or even 30. So definitely ragazzo and ragazza is not what you thought it meant in Italian, probably. Now we have different ways of saying boy and girl. We learn about ragazzo and ragazza, ragazzino e ragazzina, bambino e bambina, bambina, bambino piccolo e bambina piccola, e neonato e neonata, and how to correctly use them. So, guys, it's time to put this into practice, as I always want you to do. So, please write at least one sentence using one of these words that you learned today. You can talk about yourself or someone else, describe some member of talking about the members of your family. Use the sentences that we use today as a guideline if you need to, but please write at least one sentence and post that in a comment in the comment section down below. So share that with us. By writing this, by immediately using the vocabulary you learn and putting it into practice by writing sentences, this is going to stick. Okay, that's all for today. I hope you found this lesson helpful, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, have a great day. Buona giornata e a presto. Ciao da Valentina.